Yoshi, great job on the shirt. I like that. Maybe a little too much starch. Well, you're such a heel anyway. Hi, get everybody. This is WCW Worldwide. I'm Mean Gene Okerlund. Cinch him up, because we've got one exciting, action-packed hour coming your way. In action from the plains of Texas, Texan Shanghai. There's big news coming up on Super Brawl. The Nasty Boys with Missy Hyatt, their tag team champions, plus Stu Cold and Marcus. And Vader, also on hand this week.
Our thanks to Mean Gene Okerlund. Welcome now, fans, inside the Worldwide Arena at the Disney MGM Studios in Orlando. WCW Worldwide is on the air. Tony Schiavone and Jesse the Body Ventura.
Unforgiven.
And WCW, I guess, Unforgiven, Tex and Shanghai to begin things, Jesse.
Well, there they are, the two big Texans.
Move that camera, I'll knock you out.
Move that camera, I'll knock you out. Tex don't look in too good a mood today, Tony.
Not at all. Good to have you with us wherever you are. Worldwide. Worldwide comes your way, and great radio, great television stations all over the world. Speaking of Brian Armstrong and Scott Sandlin, two fine young athletes right there set to go. We have a tremendous program. We will take you back and take a look at what has transpired between the teacher and the protege, Ron Simmons, and Ice Train a little bit later on in this program. What has transpired with one Diamond Dallas Page, who's returned to World Championship Wrestling, and much more as we head towards Super Brawl. Mean Gene with us in the Super Brawl Control Center, and another big announcement, I understand, this week.
And it's Shanghai Pierce with a side headlock. Big shoulder off the ropes and drops the elbow.
Here's a tag.
I'll tell you what, Tony. Tag teams don't dare take this Texas team too lightly, because Shanghai and Schlesinger will beat anybody.
Brian Armstrong, tremendous second-generation wrestler, reverses the field. Big hip top. And a big arm drag.
And Armstrong with a nice reversal there on Tex Schlesinger into the arm bar. Twists it around. And makes the tag.
Scott Sand out of Indiana comes in to the Black Sandal, using the quickness and the speed to try to offset the brawling techniques and the power of Tex and Shanghai here, Jesse.
And Sandlin's caught in the wrong corner now.
Yeah, he really is.
And he's not big enough physically, I think, to get out of that corner.
Here's your double team. Roma! Odd two count. And a kick right to the chest. Here we go. Great teamwork again. Tex and Shanghai being very successful in this sport over the recent months, and thus moving up the tag team ladder, and that's been very important. They have moved up and down, and now they're as high as ever in the tag team rankings. Last time we checked, they were like fourth.
Last time they were what?
Fourth.
Fourth. And Tex Schlesinger driving those forearms in on Sandlin.
Now,
setting him up for what, a suplex?
Yep, had the front chancery on, hooked him. And look at this vertical suplex.
And he held him up there, let that blood rush down to his head, and then dropped him hard on that mat. Tag, and in comes the masked Shanghai Pierce.
Shanghai, waist lock. Whoa, dropped him on his front side after the waist lock. That's a frontal salto that time. And a tag again. Great teamwork here, Jesse. The inverted DDT, and then an elbow to boot. Oh, that's it for Salmon. One, two, three, and Tex and Shanghai looking great. What a way to begin it, Jesse.
Tex Schlesinger and Shanghai Pierce, the winners here at Disney MGM. WCW Worldwide, and the fans don't care for the two Texicans. Let's go back to replay, Tony. Here's the double team by the Texans. Double clothesline. Sandlin almost flipping over. There's the reverse DDT, followed up in tight by a big elbow. Shanghai with the cover, 1-2-3.
Tex and Shanghai get the win. Much more still to come on this edition of Worldwide. But right now, let's go to Mean Gene Okerlund.
All right, they're hanging from the rafters this week at Disney MGM in Orlando, Florida. WCW Worldwide on the air, as I remind you, Super Brawl right around the corner, Sunday, February the 20th. You can see it all exclusively on pay-per-view cable TV. In 1993, there was a very dominant tag team known as the Hollywood Blondes. No longer are they the Hollywood Blondes. They have split right now. Let's welcome to WCW Worldwide one half of that great team from last year, Brian. You know, that thing kind of went down the sewer, Brian, and in part, I guess you've got to say that Colonel Rob Parker was responsible for the split between you and Stunning Steve Austin.
I know Colonel Parker would like to fancy it as good old Southern hospitality, but let me tell you, beneath that veneer lies a cesspool of greed and wanton deceit, the very devices that led to the betrayal of my partner, the very reason Stunning Steve jumped off the Big Blonde Machine and onto Colonel Parker's golden lamb. And speaking of livestock, the more I think about it, Mean Gene, it's not Colonel Sanders that Colonel Parker reminds me anymore. Oh, no, it's a product that Colonel Sanders sold for 50-some-odd years, chicken. And if it's the last thing I do, I guarantee you something. I will pluck that chicken, and I will show my partner there's no I in team, and there's no honor in disgrace. I guarantee it.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, I've got to sort all of that out. I don't know exactly what Flying Brian meant, but I've got a feeling that we are going to find out in short order. Stunning Steve Austin certainly is target, and don't forget Colonel Rob Parker.